Clive and Elsa are scientists. They created artificial organism by crossing DNA different types of animals. This new look grown in an artificial environment. After the birth of Clive and Elsa come up with a name for him. They already have a female of the same species named Ginger. Now they brought out the male and decide to name it Fred. The process of birth and experiments are filmed by scientists. Ginger meets Fred and they show mutual sympathy, to the delight of all laboratory staff. It's time to tell about the results of the experiment to the management of the company allocating money for their development. The new form of life that Clive and Elsa bred became a source of healing protein for animal husbandry, and Joan Short is overseeing the project. Together with her at the meeting there is a lobbyist for Clive and Elsa Barlow. He promotes their developments in press. Joan intends to suspend study until the pills appear from a miracle protein can sell later. She promises to think about the next step in the introduction of human DNA to cross different species. Elsa insists on conducting such tests now, because the result may become a cure for many incurable diseases. Clive and Elsa don't want to abandon your idea. They have a DNA sample from an unnamed woman that can be used in an experiment, and they decide to simulate the situation on computer to understand whether they cross species or not. Some hours of hard work pay off. The computer model works. Now we need to try to fertilize the egg, so they will be able to test the theory in practice. Elsa locks herself in the laboratory and tries to conduct the experiment alone. Clive versus Elsa insists. She appeals to the scientific curiosity of Clive and his inferior. They just want to make sure the embryo is formed and then destroy it. Fertilization is successful. The embryo develops very fast. Because of the new project, Elsa and Clive stop isolating the protein from Fred and Ginger. They let others take care of them. Laboratory staff, including Clive's brother Gavin, he suspects that Clive is conducting some kind of forbidden experiment, but he keeps silent. Clive and Elsa live together, they meet and are already looking for a new home. However, the idyll of their evening is broken by a call from the laboratory. Premature birth has begun in the incubator. The creature that they brought out has grown to the right size and is preparing to be born, but the incubator cannot withstand the pressure. It rises pressure and Elsa has to pull the body out by hand. When the girl puts her hand into the incubator, something grabs her and bites into her hand. Clive has to smash the liquid container and rip open the incubator bag to free Elsa's hand. Falls to the floor creature with a tail. It twists and desperately fighting for life. From the bite Elsa gets sick. She is saved only by an injection delivered by Clive in time. They capture the creature and lock it up in the lab. However, what happened does not give Clive peace. He decides to kill the dangerous organism, but when he and Elsa arrive in lab it turns out that he is already dead. Scientists decide to study the dead tissue and see that something alive has come out of the creature. It runs onto legs and hides from people. Clive intends to kill the creature, but Elsa makes contact with it and convinces Clive to let him live. They put the creature to sleep and study its structure. It turns out that it develops too quickly, which means it will soon grow old and die, so Clive and Elsa decide to watch him complete life cycle. They call their H50 development. Clive returns to working with Fred and Ginger. Gavin informs him that Ginger has several days, estrogen is lowered, but the news does not puzzle Clive too much, because all his thoughts are occupied with new research. She and Elsa have closed the poisonous spike on H's tail and are trying to feed her. However, the creature refuses to take any food. At some point, it rips open Elsa's pocket and drops refreshing sugar-filled dredges. H50 immediately pounces on them. Realizing that the creature likes sugar, they began to mix these dredges into food. While Clive and Elsa are engrossed in their experiment, the main laboratory activity has been halted. Barlow informs Clive that they will be shut down if they don't turn a profit. On the 21st day of the experiment, H50 grew. Her mental faculties also developed. Elsa shows her how to make words and she writes the word nerd. This is an abbreviation, the name of the laboratory where they work, Elsa and Clive. After reading this word upside down, Elsa decides to name the creature Dren. While the two are arguing about the girl, Gavin enters the room. He overhears the conversation, but then Dren attacks him. She wants to kill him with her tail stinger, but Elsa won't let her. Clay persuades Gavin to be silent, and when he returns to Elsa and Dren, he sees that the girl is sick. She has a fever and Clive with Elsa does not know how to bring down the temperature. Clive suggests putting her in cold water. When they submerge Dren there, she fights back. Then Clive starts drowning her. They think that Dren choked, but she just learned to breathe underwater. The body they created turned out to be amphibian. Elsa has long dreamed of a child, so she takes care of Dren like her daughter. The girl is growing very fast. In terms of physical development, she has already reached adolescence. Due to work, Clive and Elsa have not been close for a very long time. They decide to do it in a hurry, and while they are busy with their business, Dren watches them from behind a curtain. Dren organized a presentation of new organisms for scientists. They want to show Fred and Ginger to the press. However, the presentation is out of control. When these beings get close, they release their stingers and start killing each other. It turned out that the laboratory staff missed the transformation of Ginger into a male. To rehabilitate, scientists must create pills from miraculous protein, and to control their work, in Barlow is sent to the lab. Clive and Elsa has to take the grown-up Dren to a country farm that belonged to Elsa's mother. They equip the girl with housing in the barn, but she immediately runs away into the forest. There she catches a hare and eats it. While Clive and Elsa are at work, Dren is on her own. She studies herself and the world around her. A cat runs into the barn and Dren catches it. When Elsa tries to feed the girl her usual food, she refuses, and Clive expresses a hunch that Dren wants meat. Dren makes it clear that she is bored around the clock sitting in the barn. She starts act up, but Elsa shows cruelty. Dren jumps up, breaks the skylight, and climbs out. So that she doesn't get hurt, Clive and Elsa climb on the roof and call Dren to her, but she stumbles and falls down. And then membranes burst out of the back and arms, which fold into wings. Thanks to them, Dren did not fall. To calm the girl down, Clive says that they love her, and Dren returns to the barn. After that incident, Clive drives to the lab alone. However, he fails to synthesize the desired protein from the dead tissues of creatures. Elsa stays in the barn with Dren. She puts on her makeup and teaches her to be a woman. Elsa notices that she has drawings of Clive, but the Dren grabs the leaves and hides them. As punishment for her bad behavior, Elsa takes her cat away from her. Returning home, Clive goes to Dren. To entertain her a little, he turns on the music and they start dancing. During the dance, Clive realizes that Elsa used her DNA to creation of Dren. He talks about it to Elsa and she doesn't deny it. After this conversation, Elsa decides to return the Dren cat, but the girl no longer needs a pet animal. She kills a cat, for which she receives a slap from Elsa. The slap infuriates her and Dren pounces on Elsa, but she did not kill her. She just took the key to go outside. Elsa took advantage moment and stunned Dren with a shovel. She then tied her to a chair and amputated the stinger on her tail. When Clive saw this and was horrified, he then untied Dren from the table and took pity on her. Elsa went to the lab to use Dren's still living flesh to create the protein she needed. As she was leaving, she met Barlow. Elsa told him that the necessary protein had been created. Clive was left at home alone. He is a little drunk and turned on the surveillance cameras to understand what Dren was doing now. The girl was swimming in her tank and it looked like she knew that Clive was watching her. When he arrived at the barn, Dren seduced him. However, they are interrupted by the returning Elsa. Seeing this, she leaves for a city apartment. Clive follows her to talk. During the conversation, both decide that they have gone too far and Dren needs to be destroyed. However, when they return to the barn, Dren is already dead. Elsa finds among her belongings drawings that depict her instead of Clive. They bury Dren behind the barn, and when they burn her things, Gavin arrives with Barlow. Having studied the protein, Barlow realized that Elsa created a new creature and he wants to see it. From the grave where Dren was buried, a winged male creature breaks out. Dren was reborn as a male. He kills Barlow and then Gavin. After this, Dren eliminates Clive and lashes out at Elsa to mate. But Clive comes to the rescue just in time. He punches him with a branch. In response, Dren kills Clive, and Elsa has to complete what he started. She crushed Dren's skull with a stone. Proximity with Dren passed without a trace. Elsa got pregnant. Joan offered her a substantial sum so that she agreed to endure and give birth to a child, and then provide him for experiments. Elsa agreed.